what we have done is that we have actually have three levels of the program. One is the foundation level courses, which are in the first term, which help you establish your concepts, etc. And then we talk about the application of these concepts into business processes, into business functions. And then in the third level is where I was talking about integration, where we do a lot of project work. We do a lot of project work in conjunction with industry. We also do social innovation projects and programs. We also do business innovation. We do a lot more design thinking. So integration is the layer where you are able to then conceptualize not only at a process level, application level, but also at an organization level. So there are three, clearly there is a step-by-step learning process, and all the various technologies that we are sort of teaching you, you know, you learn how to apply them through a virtual lab. So there is a partnership with Microsoft, which gives you access to almost 3 to 4 hours of lab time every day. And you can do project work using this lab. You can do project work on cloud. You can do project work on machine learning bench, AI bench. You can, you know, so there are various kinds of platforms open to you through this lab. At the end of the program, you also get a certification by Microsoft on the courses that you do through Microsoft. And so therefore it is a complete holistic program which enables you to develop data skills, which enables you to develop design skills, and which enables you to develop digital skills. So remember, 3Ds is where the focus is on, prepares you better for the jobs that are now coming in the market for MBAs. So therefore a tech MBA gets you the edge in the job market, at least 15 to 20% better salaries compared to the normal MBA, and also better long-term prospects, you know. So, you know, I'm going to just pause right now and maybe ask Salman to continue. Salman is the director of career services at Soil, and he will give you a much better picture of what the job market is today, and where does this program kind of fit in. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Sanjeev, and a very warm welcome to all the participants. Our regrets for the slight glitch we had in connectivity a short while ago. This glitch actually further highlights the criticality of digital technology in today's business, and that is really what Sanjeev was referring to. The pandemic has strongly reinforced the need for what we are going to be covering in this program, as he just detailed out to you. So getting specific about the career prospects, every single organization that we have talked to this year, and I mean, it's virtually without exception, they have clearly indicated this shift from traditional hiring patterns to hiring students who understand the 3Ds, as Sanjeev just referred to a short while ago, very well. So it has ceased to be, you know, a good to have kind of a feel to it. You know, we used to say these things are good to have, knowledge of digital, knowledge of data, knowledge of design. Rather, it's moved from the good to have category to the must have category. And that is the key change that has come in, particularly over the past 1 year or so. Of course, the transformation as far as you know, the requirement of data analytics and data science is concerned has been going on for quite a few years now, and digital as well. But it has just got accelerated so hugely over the past 1 year or so. Therefore, most of the requirements that we have had on the campus this year I'll not say all, that will be an inaccurate statement. So we've still had some of the old variety, you know, the more traditional roles, but most of the requirements that have come in have had some element or the other of one of the three Ds, or maybe a combination of them. Therefore, this program, we are very, very confident in the way it's been designed. And of course, you know, a lot of input has gone in, not just from our platform and technology provider, which is Microsoft, but also from a number of our consortium partners. For those of you who are not aware, Soil itself was formed through a consortium of 32 major corporates in the country, including the likes of Hindustan Unilever, Tata Steel, Infosys, the Mahindra and Mahindra Group, Aditya Birla Group. There's a number of major companies which had come together to create this institute. And all of our programs have kept pace with the requirements in the market, because these companies keep providing us inputs in terms of what is it that the market is looking for. So we've got very good inputs from our consortium partners as well when it comes to designing this program. And Sanjeev himself, of course, if you've seen his LinkedIn profile or his overall expertise areas, he has been handling digital strategy in major global companies. So we are very, very confident that with the sort of team that has put this together and the sort of faculty that we are setting up for you, we will be able to meet the requirements of all of our recruitment partners. And as I said, those requirements are very clearly pronounced now in terms of the specific areas that we have mentioned. So this is what I wanted to just convey to you. We'll of course be very happy to take your questions, but prior to that, I would like to invite a very prominent Soil alum, Sheeza Shakil, who's currently with the Accenture in Australia. And since she is handling businesses of that nature, maybe Sheeza, you can give us and our audience here a flavor of what a program like this could mean as far as corporates are concerned. Over to you.
Thanks, Salman. Good evening, everybody. And thank you, Sanjeev and Salman, for having me. It's an absolute delight. I think it reminds me of my days when, you know, I was choosing a specialization. I was passionate about technology back then, and I don't think so anything has changed, to be honest. Just let me take a step back, right? What would a successful MBA program mean? It simply, I think, means that it's preparing you to be a leader in tomorrow's day and age, right? It's all about that. We are preparing you to be leaders with new skills. You need to adapt, you need to change. And in today's day and age, it means you are changing with technology. You are bringing in digital transformation. You are preparing yourself to be a leader who's solving business problems using technology. So it's very simple. You know, it's an amalgamation of your business skills and your technology skills. And that is what the leader of tomorrow would look like, you know. And I would just explain it in two bits, okay, which each from Sanjeev and Salman, which they've covered. I would term it as an employability quotient. I would also term it as a business quotient. Now, what do I mean by employability quotient, right? You are doing this sort of a program to be employed tomorrow. Now, if you really look at the Forbes top five companies, right, with market cap, they're all technology companies. Now, any company who has made money in this pandemic era, it's a technology company. Any company which is sustained is a technology company. Any company who has been profitable, who has recruited, they are all technology companies. I think that itself explains a lot, right? But if I have to take some specific examples, right? Tomorrow you want to take up any job function, and I mean any job function in the business world, right? You want to take up an HR role. You would be using AI ML skills to probably just skim through resumes and bring in workforce diversity, kill the biases in your workforce. I'm in sales, right? Tomorrow, if you decide to take up a job in sales, then you'll be heavily banking on CRM software, you know, to do probably know the account history, do a pricing benchmark, analyze your win-loss ratios. Suppose you want to take up a job in operations, you'll be relying on a digital twin probably, AI, ML, AR, VR, all these latest technology, right, to be on top notch in your fields. So no matter what your job function is or your industry is, you would be heavily banking on technology. And if you can't avoid it, it's best that you embrace it and ace it now, because now is the time for technology. Now, coming to my second bit, right, the business quotient, what does that mean? And I would just quote an Accenture research probably. We did a research between some of the businesses which are leaders and laggards, you know, that difference pre-pandemic was about 2x. And that has now increased to 5x, you know, and that simply means that without technology, you can't even just exist. And this is not the first time that has happened, right? If you really look at the history of the companies who have survived, it is because of technology. Every time a company decided to, you know, change its course, adapt, evolve, bank on technology, use technology rather than, you know, fearing it, they have excelled in their domains, right? And tomorrow as leaders, right, you are going to solve some of the most toughest business problems, complex problems, real life problems, a vaccine rollout probably, which is happening right now. It could not have been done without technology. As Accenture and any of the IT firms, we are solving some of the most complex world problems like climate change, you know, human trafficking, age care, worker safety. All of these has been possible only because of technology. And any leader who is able to bridge this gap between technology, business, able to find relevance of what this business means to technology and vice versa, will be able to excel. And that is why, I mean, I personally, when I look at this from an industry perspective, I feel that this is a very, very relevant skill in today's day and age. And I think this is the right time. It is one of the kind, and it won't happen again and again. So I think that's my view, Salman, and I hope this helps some of the students decide, because I'm very, very, you know, excited about this program. And this is probably the best time.
Sure. Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you very much, Iza. I think that was a very, very well articulated.
Looks like Sanjeev has, you know, again, there's some issue with his connectivity. So while he's coming back on, I would now like to request our audience to ask us any questions or address any queries that you may have with regard to the program, its employability, anything that comes to your mind. We are absolutely open to your questions. So please go ahead. So one of the questions which has already come in from Sharad, he says, for me, tech MBA makes sense, but will I be more of a technical person or a management sort of a person if I choose this track? I think this is exactly, you know, we are taking away the distinction between those two, Sharad. I think that is the key to what all of us have just told you. You need not be either a technology person or a management person. The management person, and the man by management person, we are referring to people with the right leadership skills that Shiza referred to when she was talking a short while ago. So those leaders now need to be equipped adequately with technology. They need to understand how technology can make them take better informed decisions, formulate better strategies for the growth of their organizations, for the betterment of their employees, all of those things put together. Therefore, the key to what you've just asked me is that or rather the key to your question, which was that these two are two separate areas, I would say they are not. We are looking at the same person, which means if you sign on for this program, you become a leader, of course. You become a leader in your organization, which you will be joining, and you become a better equipped and a better informed leader. That is the whole idea behind the program. So I hope I have answered your question. Sanjeev, we had just lost you for a minute. I had taken on the first question from Sharad. So there is the next question, which has already come in from Saurabh. What is the work experience? Who can take this program? I'm 12 years experience and looking for data science. Sanjeev, do you want to answer that?
Yeah. So I think we are looking for some experience here, Sharad. So I think, a 10 to 12 year experience is a good experience because, we can look for lateral positions for placement. After we have given you this kind of skill in this program, because your skill level will go up by quantum levels, the way we have kind of planned the program. And this will give you a good launching pad to get into more managerial positions. So let us be clear, this is a tech MBA program. This is not a pure tech program. So if you have the data science background, then this is an ideal program for you to kind of, step up your learning and, aim for a better managerial position. So does that answer your question, Sharad? Yeah.
Correct. So your 12 years experience should actually come in very handy. You'll be a good person to join this program. Hmm. Okay, other questions? And if some of you want to raise your hand and we can unmute you, you can speak as well, whatever you prefer. Or you can type in your questions as these two have done.
So Saurabh says, what is course curriculum which I missed? So do you want me to show the course curriculum? We had it in the brochure, but if you want, I can show it.
I think that may be a good idea, Sanjeev. Can just put it up, share your screen. And, I think it'll be to everyone's benefit.
Okay. Yeah, can you see the, can you see my screen? Hello?
Yeah, we can.
Yes, we can.
Okay. So I'm just gonna go a little, just one second. If you've gone through the brochure, we have the curriculum here. Yeah, this is where it is. So in the curriculum, the 300 hours, so it is totally 1400 hours of contact time. In that, about 300 hours are fundamental management courses and fundamental data analytics courses and digital domain learning courses, which is 1, 2, and 3 here. So those are the courses which are taken typically in the first term, okay? And then we have business analytics, which is fair amount of detail, item number 5 here, you know. And in that we cover all the various kinds of business analytics, which is related to different business functions like finance or customer analytics, marketing, even industry oriented analytics problems, HR oriented, digital analytics. So this is in term 2 in fair amount of detail. And then we have digital applications like IoT or blockchain, automation, cybersecurity. We've covered some fundamental elements of machine learning and cloud in the first term itself, but there'll be some more of that here. And then we go into, in the second term, towards the end of the second term, we have programs on design thinking. And then there is a lot of integrated learning that we do through consulting skills, simulation, change management, project management. That is more of the integration in term 3. And in term 2 and term 3, we have fairly close interaction with industry. We have a lot of live projects. We have industry mentorship. We have case competitions. We have industry live projects. And then all along, there is a Microsoft Intelligent Cloud Hub program going on, which is open, where you can do self-learning through access to all their AI, IoT systems. And there is total 60,000 hours available, which means about 3 to 4 hours per student. So this is how this whole program curriculum is kind of designed. And I, of course, didn't talk too much about the social innovation program, which is a hallmark of SOIL. But that is, again, something which we do in term 2 and term 3. And here, again, we are going to see the application of analytics and digital in social innovation programs, right? So any other questions on this curriculum, or is this clear?
There are some other questions which have come in, Sanjeev.
Yeah, okay.
So Harjot is asking, I have 7.4 years of approximate experience in IT services and consulting and want to pivot towards a business role in IT analytics digital domain. His current CTC is 18 lakhs per annum. Am I a good fit for the program? Harjot, I'll attempt an answer to this. First is, your background renders you as a very strong candidate for this program. Very clearly, I mean, this program will be of immense benefit for you. There is absolutely no doubt about it. And since you mentioned that you wish to pivot in that direction, it is definitely going to be very beneficial. Now, the key to it is going to be the second part, which is the current CTC that you've indicated. We feel that with your experience and your kind of, current, the 7.5 years of experience that you carry, there are good lateral positionings that our placement team can work out for you, which should help you to improve on that number. The normal, let me, however, add a note of caution. The normal roles that, companies come to the campus for would possibly not be in that range. I do not wish to give you a false picture. However, given your background and the fact that there could be lateral openings that we could look at for somebody like you, once you've gone through this kind of a program, my feeling is you should be able to achieve that number and exceed it quite happily. So I hope I've answered that question for you. From purely a fitness for the program perspective, my answer is absolutely yes. On the compensation side, we will be working on all of our students from a lateral placement perspective, particularly people with your kind of high experience profile and high salary profile.
Yeah, there's one more thing I want to add, Harjot. You should not look at it only from a compensation point of view. You should also look at it from a long-term career perspective. The insights which you will get through this program will prepare you for a solid career in a managerial position. That is what you're looking for. I think you're looking for a business-oriented role. You're not looking for entirely a technical oriented role. So this will help you to go and become a vice president or a senior vice president or that level. you know, whereas I don't know whether if you don't have a management degree or a management program orientation, it will take you more time. So you should look at it from a career, long-term career perspective also, rather than just the immediate salary comparison.
Okay, Sanjeev, there's a question. Is this program suitable for a person who's a BCom graduate with 3 years of experience in finance?
Yeah, so let me answer that. You see, we don't distinguish in terms, we are not orienting this program only for engineering graduates, okay? So we have actually we have actually got a stream for finance people in financial analytics and in the banking area, because the financial technology is where a lot of innovation and transformation is happening. So we are actually kind of created a specialization already in soil on financial technology in fintech and in financial analytics. So, and we are further teaming up with the various institutes who have excellence in finance to bring in their expertise also. From an aspect of digital design and data. So if you have orientation towards data and you have orientation towards analytics, BCom is not a limitation.
Absolutely. Yeah. So Sanjeev, the next one is Sharad has again asked about the roles. The roles that are offered or coming up for this program. So Sharad, if I may attempt an answer there, Sharad, the roles are going to be in each of these three key areas that we've talked about, which is digital strategy, digital transformation, which is data science, and which is design, all three. And there are combinations of these three as well that you can expect. Therefore, a data scientist, a senior data scientist, then you get into people who will do digital strategies in their organization. I mean, there's a number of these streams that will open up. And these are, of course, over and above the roles that you get anyway for, people with a good technology orientation, roles in business analysis, etc., where you become, analysts for specific business domains. You can, if you are joining top IT and consulting companies, you can look for roles in around pre-sales consulting. You can look for roles in post-sales as well. So there's a number of these opportunities which will open up in each of the three key domains which we are referring to over here. Sanjeev and Shiza, do you want to add to that?
Yes, Salman. So I agree. I think strategy and consulting is one area which will open up. And this is different from a general management, right? Because I can see this, that strategy and consulting areas are really picking up because for digital transformation, I mean, a lot of times often, people feel that having a website or an online portal is digital transformation. It isn't. So when you are equipped with all these different skills in cloud, IoT, AI, ML, digital, then you are able to better consult the customer and solve their business problems, So I think strategy and consulting is one field which will open up for the graduates.
Okay. Moving to the other questions which have come up.
There is on the chat, there is a question on with COVID numbers rising, will this be an online program? Also, what is the fee for the program? Can you give an example of the career path that is possible? I'm working in IBM for the last 2 years as a developer. Okay. It will be a hybrid program. See, now online courses will continue to happen. At least 20 to 30% going forward will be online. I mean, even if everything opens out, let's say by August, September, you know, there's a lot of faculty which we are using from the US or from elsewhere, you know, which will continue to be online. And since we are giving access to the Microsoft virtual lab, the online is not a limitation, right? But at the same time, our intention is that there should be a lot of peer contact, there should be that feeling of a campus, and we know that there's lots more excitement once you are together as a team. So, but the blending learning model is now kind of become de facto, will become de facto with most management institutes, right? So we will also be in that part because that gives you the best of learning, right? So that is as far as the, you know, model of teaching is concerned. As far as fees concerned, it's equivalent to the fee that we are charging for the BLP or HRLP program, which is there in the brochure. Maybe Salman, you can explain a little bit about the career roles, or if you want to elaborate a little more on the fee part.
Yeah. Sure, sure. I'll just add a bit more on the online part, which is the first part of his question. So Mayank, we are towards the end of this month, or hopefully early part of April, planning to go on that blended route that Sanjeev just referred to. So quite a few of our students, by the way, have landed up, and we have a you know, residential facility, a hostel sort of where, you know, with all due precautions on sanitation, etc., the students have moved in, the quarantine period is over, and now they have started coming to the campus regularly. So that process has already commenced for us. We are hopeful once the vaccination situation, you know, improves over the next few days and weeks to bring in more and more of our students onto the campus. However, I think Sanjeev is absolutely right. The blended model is going to continue because there is, you know, we still do not see a complete return to the quote unquote old normal, if I may use that phrase loosely. It's unlikely, you know, in the near future. We have already equipped our classrooms, or we are in the process of equipping our classrooms with all the cameras, etc., that are needed to ensure a successful delivery of the hybrid program. And therefore, hopefully, come maybe early to mid-April, we should be fully into that hybrid mode. Now, the career path, I think we just talked about it in response to the previous question. So I hope that your query was addressed. Your question, though, is about the career path. So we've talked about the possible areas in which, you know, your career can progress. And by the way, the careers that we have referred to are going to exist across all functional domains. Therefore, regardless of whether, you know, you have an orientation towards supply chain or towards human resource or towards marketing, sales and marketing, there will be digital and analytics-based options that open up for you in those spaces. So don't just restrict it to specialized roles in digital strategy and analytics. Also look at the application of these platforms and technologies in the traditional roles, right? So it's a huge world out there that is waiting for you as far as careers are concerned. So I hope I've answered your question. Your last part is you working in IBM for the last 2 years. Yes, absolutely. Your profile lends itself very well. We see someone like you who has some background in IT as being a good fit. Am I right, Sanjeev?
Yeah, absolutely. Because I mean, whatever you say about 50-60% jobs are in the IT sector.
Yes. You
know? So definitely it will help a lot to have that kind of background.
Yes. Okay. Have we handled all the queries and any new?
Yeah, there's just one query more, which is coming in from Sharad. What is the benefit of Microsoft certification? Okay, let me answer this. See, the benefit is that when you get into a lot of industry today, Microsoft Azure, in almost 50% of the companies, Microsoft is the de facto platform, right? Because their penetration into enterprise systems is very high. Okay? And so therefore, if you have a certification, it kind of gives you a little sort of standing in the industry, in your job, etc. And it sort of provide some credentials. And that is the importance, because otherwise you can study many things, but do you really have that rigor? Do you really have the ability? Because we insist that there should be at least some 100 practice hours that you put in before the certificate is given to you. Okay? And you also pass various exams and practice sessions. So we are not looking at just creating theoretical people out of this program. We are looking at creating practitioners who can, if required, implement certain things. You know, you don't have to be a programmer, but you should have the ability to understand the various platforms and perform certain functions. Okay, if you're going to guide a team, ultimately as a manager you have to guide a team, so you should know how to do it, right? And this certification basically lends you the credentials, so that's why it's got a certain value. Yeah, Shiza, go on.
I would just like to add, you know, I am into solution selling. So basically, you know, per the traditional model, it would have been okay for me not to know so much technical aspects, because it's like we all would assume. But as part of being in Accenture, right, I am myself a Microsoft certified Azure professional. I am an Amazon cloud practitioner. So these credentials, they give more meat to what you speak, right? Even if you take up a job in sales, and I think this is precisely what Salman and Sanjeev is, I think, trying to convince you guys, that all the career options remain the same. But this tech MBA would put more weight to whatever you would do, even if it is a sales function, you know, tomorrow, or it's a pre-sales function, or you want to go definitely into analytics. So your career options are everything as general management plus plus. So, you know, if I have to just conclude that way. And credentials are definitely very important. And if I think there was some recent research where they've said that now recruiters are, when they're scouting for profiles, they specifically look for hashtag Microsoft certified and things like that. You know, again, banking heavily on searches where, you know, Microsoft appears. So I think it will bring in further credibility to whatever you are doing in whichever field, you know. Thanks, sir.
Yeah, thanks, Shiza. And Mayank is also further asking whether I can do specialization in digital marketing as part of this program. Yes, definitely, Mayank. There is going to be different cohorts within this program itself. There will be a finance cohort. There will be a marketing cohort, operations cohort. So various cohorts will be HR cohort. So definitely you can realize your dream to be a digital marketing expert, once you opt for this program. Yeah. So Sharad has thanked you. Yeah. So
any other questions from the participants and or the attendees?
I think we are done, right? Yeah. Right. So let me just close by thanking all of you who have attended towards the webinar, and I wish you all the best, and I hope you can take the right decisions. I'd like to also thank Salman and Shiza for taking out your time. Shiza particularly, because she's at a very odd time right now. It must be more than 11 o'clock in the night in Melbourne, right? But really, thanks for stretching it out and chipping in. Really appreciate. And so I think with that, we can kind of conclude today's webinar. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thanks to all of you.
Thanks a lot. Thanks.
Thank you. All the best, guys. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye.